April 8, 2024 will mark a memorable moment in the North American sky with an astronomical event that promises to enchant millions of spectators, the Great American Eclipse. The total solar eclipse, a phenomenon in which the moon passes between the Earth and the sun, completely obscuring the latter, will turn day into night for some unforgettable minutes. This eclipse will be particularly special due to the moon's close proximity to Earth, which will make its apparent diameter larger than usual and allow for prolonged totality of up to 4 minutes and 28 seconds in places like Nazas and Torreón in Mexico. The eclipse's path will cross North America, touching Mexico, the United States, and Canada, offering a rare opportunity for direct observation of this celestial spectacle. It is estimated that nearly 32 million people live within the totality zone, and all of them can enjoy the show simply by opening the windows of their homes. But they will be joined by at least 70 million Mexican, American, and Canadian tourists. All these people will embark on a journey to reach the nearest or most desirable location from where they can observe this incredible phenomenon. In addition to direct observation in the totality zones, the eclipse will be partially visible in various other regions of the world, offering a fascinating spectacle even to those far from the narrow band of totality. This extraordinary video, prepared for you by the Insane Curiosity Channel, will provide all the necessary information for you to enjoy this incredible cosmic miracle. Just 7 years ago, on August 21st, 2017, the shadow of a total eclipse crossed the United States from the Pacific to the Atlantic. But as thrilling as it may have been, the 2024 eclipse will somehow be even better. The totality will last on average almost 2 minutes longer, which means that along most of the path of the moon's shadow, observers will witness the grand phenomena of the solar corona's appearance for over 4 minutes. Moreover, this time, the shadow will cross much more populous regions of North America than those reached by the 2017 eclipse. This time, as already mentioned, there are 32 million people residing within the band that the moon's shadow will traverse from southwest to northeast, touching cities like Dallas, Little Rock, Indianapolis, Cleveland, and Buffalo, with San Antonio, Austin, Cincinnati, and the Canadian city of Montreal right at the end. With many more millions of people living within a few hours' drive, April's event could become one of the most watched celestial events in history. But wait a minute. Before delving into the description of this epical event, it would be wise to familiarize ourselves with some basic astronomical knowledge, just enough to understand the significance of what is about to happen. Hang on a sec, guys, before we continue. Be sure to join the Insane Curiosity Channel. Click on the bell, you will help us to make products of even higher quality. The phenomena of solar eclipses occurs when the moon passes directly between the Earth and the sun, covering the latter's disk entirely or partially. This type of eclipse can only occur at the moment of the moon's conjunction with the sun, namely during the new moon phase. But that's not all. There's an even stricter geometric condition that must be met. The three objects must be almost perfectly aligned, and this can only happen when the moon is in conjunction with the sun and simultaneously close to a node of its orbit around the Earth. If the moon's orbit lay on the same plane as the ecliptic, the plane on which the Earth moves around the sun, then a total solar eclipse would occur at every full moon, every month. If this doesn't happen, it's because the lunar orbit is inclined to the ecliptic just enough to keep the moon from lining up perfectly with the sun and the Earth. In practice, at the moment of conjunction, the moon, as seen from the Earth, passes very close to the north or south of the solar disk. What is truly essential for an eclipse, partial or total, to occur is that our satellite is at that moment passing through one of the points of intersection of the two orbital planes. Only if all these conditions are met will the cone of shadow projected by the solar light striking the moon have the opportunity to touch the Earth's surface, obscuring a part of it. And if we're talking about possibility rather than certainty, it's because the length of the cone, which varies between 367,300 and 379,800 kilometers due to the eccentricity of Earth's orbit, is always shorter than the average distance between Earth and the moon, which is 384,400 kilometers. This means that the moon's shadow can reach Earth only when our satellite is near perigee. Otherwise, the moon's shadow, being too short, will only lead to an annular eclipse. With this clarified, it will then be easy to understand that the section of the shadow cone destined to touch the Earth's surface will be larger than the smaller Earth-Moon distance and the greater the distance between the Moon and the Sun at that moment. In the case of April 8th, the eclipse will occur just one day after the Moon reaches the perigee, so the apparent diameter of our satellite will be 5.5% larger than average. Even in the most favorable combination, the section of the shadow cone on Earth never exceeds 267 kilometers in diameter, with an average of 120 kilometers, while the penumbra, which identifies the regions where the Sun's disk will be partially eclipsed, extends on average for 6,400 kilometers. The width of the shadow is also directly correlated with the duration of totality, which only rarely exceeds 7 minutes. Moreover, due to the combined movements of Earth and Moon, the shadow moves on the Earth's surface very rapidly, moving from west to east at a speed that can exceed 2,000 kilometers per hour. As a result, the so-called path of totality appears to unfold among the affected regions as a thin dark trace, sometimes longer than 15,000 kilometers. The place where the longest duration of totality occurs is called the point of greatest eclipse. In the solar eclipse of April 8th, Nazas, Mexico will have this privilege. Here, the total eclipse will last for 4 minutes and 28 seconds. Furthermore, Nazas also has the highest statistical probability of clear skies compared to other locations along the path of totality. The average frequency of a total solar eclipse for a given point on Earth is 375 years. From the entire Earth's surface in 1 year to 2 to 5 solar eclipses of any type can be observed. However, statistics tell us that in 72% of cases, there are only 2 eclipses per year. The maximum duration of totality can reach, in extremely rare cases, 7.5 minutes, as will happen on July 16, 2186, but typically does not exceed 2 to 3 minutes. Among the total eclipses that have occurred or will occur from year 0 to year 4000, only 33 exceed 7 minutes. However, if we also consider the partial phases, the duration of a solar eclipse can exceed 4 hours. The record is 4.44 hours, recorded during the annular eclipse on December 14, 1955. The maximum duration of an annular eclipse is 12.5 minutes. Great! With the necessary information at hand, let's start by saying that the total solar eclipse of April 8, 2024 will begin over the southern Pacific Ocean and then continue in Mexico. It will then enter the United States and Texas and cross Oklahoma, Arkansas, Missouri, Illinois, Kentucky, Indiana, Ohio, Pennsylvania, New York, Vermont, New Hampshire, and Maine. Even small areas of Tennessee and Michigan will experience this total solar eclipse. The eclipse will then move into Canada and southern Ontario and continue through Quebec, New Brunswick, Prince Edward Island, and Cape Breton. In the United States, totality will begin in Texas at 13:27 Central Daylight Time and end in Maine at 15:35 Eastern Daylight Time on April 8th. Here's some advice on the best locations to check out if you don't live within the path of totality. Alright, let's start with Mexico, where the shadow of the Moon will first make contact with the Pacific coast. The shadow cone will touch the land for the first time near Mazatlan, Mexico. Totality here is up to 4 minutes and 20 seconds along the central line. Other major Mexican cities along the path include Torreón and Durango. Mazatlan, a beach city in northwestern Mexico, is an excellent location to experience the Great American Eclipse. The local astronomical society will set up about 10 observation stations along the shoreline facing the Pacific. Special glasses for safely viewing the eclipse will be distributed at each station, and astronomers and telescopes will be available to make your experience unforgettable. At a speed of 1,800 kilometers per hour, the shadow will then glide into Texas, where it will gradually cover the cities of San Antonio, Austin, Dallas, and Fort Worth. Texas will attract many eclipse chasers due to its better chances of good weather, numerous hotel rooms, and a vast highway system, which is crucial if a last-minute transfer to clear skies is needed. In Dallas, the total eclipse will begin at 13:40 Central Daylight Time. Waco, Texas is another city worth considering for viewing the total solar eclipse. Here, totality will last for 4 minutes and 30 seconds, with ample chances of clear skies. On April 8th, Waco will host the Eclipse Over Texas 2024 event, featuring educational activities, telescopes, food trucks, and plenty of family-friendly fun. Astronomers from Lowell Observatory will also be present. After Texas, the Moon's shadow will traverse Kansas, passing very close to St. Louis. Arkansas will be an attractive spot to witness the eclipse, with both Texarkana, bordering Texas, and Little Rock within the path of totality. Next up is Illinois, where Carbondale, beginning at 1:59 p.m. Central Daylight Time, will have the fortune of experiencing a total solar eclipse just 7 years after the one on August 21, 2017. In the Midwest, Indianapolis and Cleveland share the distinction of being fairly central in the path of totality. In northern New York State, Buffalo and Niagara Falls could be highly attractive, although early April tends to bring cloudy skies. Key cities along the path of totality include Indianapolis, Dayton, Toledo, Cleveland, and Akron. Nearby metropolitan areas along the path include Cincinnati, Detroit, and Pittsburgh. Extremely heavy traffic is expected along the route in the early morning hours of April 8, 2024. In the northeastern United States, Niagara Falls will naturally be a favorite spot for many and a picturesque spectacle for eclipse landscape photographers. Other cities along the path include Buffalo, Rochester, Syracuse, Burlington, and Presque Isle. New York City, Boston, Washington, D.C., and Philadelphia, on the other hand, will be within 300 kilometers of the path of totality, so only a partial eclipse will be visible from there. Still beautiful, but obviously nothing can compare to a total eclipse. And it's important to emphasize this. Just being a kilometer outside the path of the shadow can nullify almost all of the eclipse's magic. If the moon doesn't cover the solar disk 100%, even the tiniest sliver of sunlight left uncovered would illuminate the sky, preventing phenomena like the solar corona from manifesting in all its glory. So the motto for everyone should be, don't settle, overcome laziness, and reach the path, especially considering that this eclipse will occur during a period of maximum solar activity. So the corona will appear much larger and more turbulent than in 2017. In Canada, Montreal will barely touch the path of totality. The line then returns to the United States, crossing northern Maine, which would be an excellent location if the weather is good. Then back to Canada's maritime provinces, with New Brunswick, Prince Edward Island, and Newfoundland all in the line of darkness. In Hamilton, the peak of totality lasting 2 minutes and 27 seconds will occur at 3:19 p.m. If instead you're up for an adventure seeking out unknown locales, we recommend visiting the link eclipse2024.org/eclipse-simulator, which will provide information on eclipse timings and the best location for each point along the path of totality. Additionally, the website will show you a simulation of the eclipse as it would be seen from your chosen location. All good so far, but what about the threat of bad weather? Which regions along the path of totality would be best to avoid unpleasant surprises after a journey that may have lasted several hours to reach the chosen location? While the 2017 eclipse occurred at the end of summer, the 2024 eclipse is a spring event, which unfortunately means a high chance of clouds. In simpler terms, the meteorological prospects are better in Mexico and become progressively uncertain as you move towards Canada. In the United States, the best solution is certainly Texas, as close as possible to the Mexican border. Central Texas is still quite good, with about a 50% chance of clear skies during that time of year. So the prospects worsen progressively as you move northeastward. These locations in particular seem to be the most promising in absolute. Melchor Muzquiz, Mexico, Allende, Mexico, Piedras Negras, Mexico, Eagle Pass, Texas, Kerrville, Texas, Fredericksburg, Texas, Lampasas, Texas. From these locations, it will be possible to observe the eclipse with the longest totality duration, more than 4 minutes and 20 seconds, and with the highest probability of mostly clear skies, 58 to 59% chances of mostly clear skies on the day of the eclipse. Many other locations in Mexico and Texas will in any case provide good chances of observing the eclipse, with a probability greater than 50% of having mostly clear skies. In short, at this time of year, the risk of cloud cover is not entirely negligible. And as often happens in life, as in other matters, the only way to ward off the fear of disappointment is simply to take it in stride and with lightness. After all, chasing an eclipse is a gamble, but it's also an adventure. Whatever the conditions of the sky, the landscape will continue to darken significantly during totality. And even with cloudy skies, the dark landscape painted by a total eclipse in progress will still seem mysterious and primal. The surrounding environment will undergo momentary but intense transformations. There will be a noticeable drop in temperatures, which can fall rapidly, and there will be, cloudy or not, changes in the behavior of animals. These changes add another level of fascination to an already incredible natural spectacle, capturing the interest not only of astronomers and night sky enthusiasts, but also of nature lovers and simple curious souls. And one more thing, this eclipse will last for over 4 minutes, which is a lot for this kind of phenomenon. But when you're in the field, you realize that seconds slip through your fingers like grains of sand. So don't waste time, especially if this is your first eclipse, arguing with your camera or other equipment. Look up at the sky safely and interact with the universe without thinking about anything else. The total solar eclipse of 2024 is an appointment with history, a moment of collective sharing of an experience that deeply touches the sense of wonder and curiosity inherent in each of us. It is an opportunity to connect with nature and the global community in a celebration of science and the beauty of the universe that surrounds us. So take advantage of it and listen to the response of your heart.